Hello everyone, welcome to biology class. In this class we are going to see 12th standard botany chapter 5 plant tissue culture. In this part of the video we'll see about the types of plant tissue culture and the production of secondary metabolites. First, the types of plant tissue culture. So how they are classified into different types. So the plant tissue culture can be classified into different types based on the explant that we are going to select. So based on this explant, the plant tissue culture is classified as organ culture, meristem culture, protoplast culture and cell culture. First topic is organ culture. The culture of the embryos, anther, ovary, root, shoot or other organs of the plant. So any other organ, if it is cultured on culture media, that kind of culture is called as organ culture. So selecting any organ, for example, so see in this picture, so the leaf is selected, okay, and from the leaf the isolated cells are taken, and the cells are cultured in culture medium to give rise to the formation of callus. Later plantlets are made and the plantlets are hardened to the natural environment. So since we are taking organ, this is referred to as organ culture. The second kind of plant tissue culture is meristem culture. So the culture of any meristematic tissue on culture media. So where is this meristematic tissue is found? Meristematic tissue will be found in the growing regions. Okay, so this is the meristematic culture. So older leaves are removed from a cutting. And the shoot tip, the growing tip, okay, so it is taken, and this growing tip will be consisting of the meristem, so which is selected, okay, and it is cultured in culture media. Such a kind is referred to as meristem culture. So if organ is cultured, organ culture, meristem tissue is cultured, it is called meristematic culture. The third kind is called protoplast culture. So what are protoplast? Protoplast are cells without a cell wall. Okay, the cell, plant cells, they consist of cell wall, but protoplast are cells without cell wall, but they are bounded by a cell membrane or plasma membrane. So we can use this protoplast and we can regenerate the whole plant from single cells, and we can also develop the somatic hybrids. So how we have to isolate this protoplast? The steps, how we can culture the protoplast. For that, the first step is isolation of protoplast. The plant tissue, for example, like leaf tissue, it is used for isolation of protoplast. First, the leaf tissue is immersed in 0.5% macrozyme and 2% Onazuka cellulase enzyme. Actually, it is mesozyme enzyme and 2% Onazuka cellulase enzymes dissolve in 13% sorbitol or mannitol at pH 5.4. So, you have to note down this pH 5.4. So, when it is immersed, it is then incubated overnight, okay, at 25 degree Celsius. And after the incubation of overnight incubation, you have to take the cells and gently tease the cells so that the cell wall will be removed and protoplast are obtained. And the obtained protoplast are transferred to 20% sucrose solution to retain their viability. So that is, to retain its activity, it is immediately after the removal of the cell wall, the protoplast are transferred to 20% sucrose solution. Then it is centrifuged. Okay, with that solution itself, it is centrifuged. This centrifugation will remove the debris, okay, that is the waste, remnants of the cell wall, and we will get the pure protoplast. So this step is referred to as isolation of protoplast. The second step, fusion of protoplast. So we are going to select different protoplast and we can fuse the protoplast. So for this fusion, it needs a suitable fusogen. And the normal fusogen is polyethylene glycol, PEG. So the isolated protoplast, they are incubated in 25 to 30% concentration of PEG with calcium ions. And the protoplast will show agglutination. That is, they fuse, they clump together and hence they fuse. The third step is called culture of protoplast. So the Murashiji Skoog liquid medium is used with some modification. Okay, in droplet technique or plating or micro drop array technique. And protoplast viability is tested with fluorescein diacetate. Okay, whether it is viable or not. Then only it will give rise to new cells. So we have to check whether it is viable. And after the cultures are incubated in continuous light, 1000 to 2000 lux at 25 degree Celsius. Then the cell wall formation will occur within 24 to 48 hours and the first division of new cells occurs between 2 to 7 days of culture. Selection of somatic hybrid cells. The fusion product of protoplast without the nucleus of different cell is called as cybrid. Okay. That is, without the nucleus, the protoplast alone, if it fuses, it is called as cybrid. And following this, okay, after the formation of a cybrid, the nucleus will then fuse, and this process is called somatic hybridization. So this is the illustration which shows the protoplast culture. So how it is, the leaf is taken, the leaf is sterilized, okay, and epidermis is peeled, and they are making ready the separating the cell wall, and then they are plating the collecting the protoplast and plating the protoplast. Okay, they are able to fuse. Okay, and callus is regenerated and it give rise to a plantlet. This is the protoplast culture. The last kind of plant tissue culture is cell suspension culture. The growing of cells, including the culture of single cells or small aggregates of cells in vitro in liquid medium. Okay, so they are going to grow the cells in liquid medium is called cell suspension culture. Even the cell suspension, how it can be prepared? We can take the callus. Okay, so during plant tissue culture, it will give rise to callus, no? So the callus, a portion of the callus can be taken and it can be transferred to the liquid medium and it is agitated. Okay, so last class, I have told you what is agitation. So in the plant tissue culture, I have told you what is agitation. And the liquid medium can be agitated using a rotary shaker instrument. So as it is agitated or as it is shaked with this instrument, the cells are separated because callus is the unorganized mass of cells. So from the cells are separated and these cells are used for cell suspension culture. So we have seen now the four different types of plant tissue culture. The next topic is production of secondary metabolites. So the cell suspension culture can be useful for production of secondary metabolites. What are the name of the different secondary metabolites? Alkaloids, flavonoids, terpenoids, phenolic compounds and recombinant proteins. So the secondary metabolites are chemical compounds. So it can be asked in 2 mark this point. They are chemical compounds that are not required by the plant for normal growth and development, but are produced in the plant as byproducts of cell metabolism. So you know all living organism will undergo metabolism. So out of metabolism, whatever it is produced, it is called metabolites. So the metabolites are classified into 2 kinds. One is primary metabolites and the other one is secondary metabolites. The primary metabolites are very essential for the organism's normal growth and development. So the primary metabolites are utilized by them. So in addition to that, they produce some byproducts. Those are referred to as secondary metabolites. These secondary metabolites are chemical compounds which are not required for its own growth. So we are going to take these byproducts and it can be used. For example, biosynthesis and isolation of indole alkaloids from Catharanthus roseus plant cell culture. The process of production of secondary metabolites can be scaled up and automated. Okay, so by using bioreactors. So using bioreactors, we can produce enormous quantities of secondary metabolites from the culturing of microorganisms or in a plant cells. Many strategies such as biotransformation, elicitation and immobilization have been used to make cell suspension culture more efficient in the production of secondary metabolites. The following table is a very important answer. They are asking different kinds of secondary metabolites, industrially important plant secondary metabolites. So the table goes like this: secondary metabolites, plant source and use. The first one is digoxin. So it is taken from the plant Digitalis purpurea and it is used as a cardiac tonic to improve the heart function. Codeine, okay, it is taken from Papaver somniferum and it is used as analgesic for pain relieving. Next, capsaicin. So it is taken from Capsicum annuum and it is used for rheumatic pain treatment. So the joint pain. And vincristine, it is taken from Catharanthus roseus. So it has got anti-carcinogenic. Okay, it will treat against the cancer. So anti-carcinogenic. Next, the very popular quinine. Okay, so it is taken from Cinchona officinalis and it is used as anti-malarial drug. So this table is quite important. So they will ask the question as list out some industrially important plant secondary metabolites. So you have to write fully including the plant source and its uses. So in this class we have seen different types of plant tissue culture. Okay, we have seen about the organ culture and also we have seen about the protoplast culture and we have seen about the meristem culture and cell suspension culture. And also we have seen about the secondary metabolites that are obtained from plants. Meet you in the next video. Thank you.